Yo, what's good with y'all, man? I already know what time it is. It's your boy Trez TV. In the flesh, in the building. I already know what time it is. What? Bing! We finna get into it, man. New crib, new place, new room, new content. Y'all already know what time it is. 2024 about to come out. What can I say? Bruh. We about to watch this. We about to get into this. We about to get into this 2K24 trailer because it just dropped. I just got weird. It just dropped. I seen Duke Dennis had reacted to it, and I was supposed to do a video on Duke Dennis reacting to it too. Cause I got you kind of want to keep up with, you know, the unbiased players in the community and stuff. You feel me? And Duke Dennis, he an OG, bro. We've been keeping up with Duke Dennis for the longest, but. I wanna look at this. I wanna see this trailer myself and see what it's talking about, bro. Cause boy, 23. It's been a crazy year with this game. I don't really know what to say about the future of 2K, man. I mean, personally is. It's good to adapt to, you know, if you're a pretty decent player. But other than, you know, the other stuff like shooting and defense and dunking, bro, I could say 23 was a very skilled but unskilled game this year. It was kind of in the middle. It was like if you knew how to play, then that's a plus for you. But even then, even knowing how to play, you still get some dumb stuff happening like. Late release timings, like you'll have at least 5 different releases for every shot that you have. You'll have a new jump shot. It will be a different release for every court that you play on. So like the bridge threes, that's a different three. That's a different shot. That's different timing. You go to the galleon. That's a different shot timing. Then you go to the rec. The rec is a different shot timing. Then you go to the laggy threes Gatorade court, but that's the laggiest court in the neighborhood, bro. And it's like, the defense is OP. Really, if you got a good perimeter defense, you can really just sit. You can sit in the paint and play the paint and the three-point line all at the same time. If you're playing like threes, bro, I could guard all three players at one time just by sitting, just by, you feel me, sliding around the paint. This game was so inconsistent. Same with green lights. You get late greens. You cannot tell me why we have late greens. You can't tell me why. If the shot is a make, it's gonna be a make regardless. If somebody wants to run down the court and cherry pick, they're gonna cherry pick regardless of that green late, bro. It's late. It's a late green. Nobody knows if you made it or not. So if you miss. Dude's still gonna be down the court regardless. If he make it, he gonna be down the court regardless. I don't understand the concept behind it, but you know, somehow I still came out and managed to play through the BS. You feel me? I still managed to play through it. Still managed to have my fun. Like even though the game was trash this year, I was still playing it. I was still playing this trash game this year. I was still winning. I was still above a 50% win percentage, and all I did was play with randoms. That's all I did. I played with randoms this entire year. I played with randoms 2022 the entire year. I probably found like a good duo, a good trio, like later on in the year. But 2K about to be over with, bro. Like 24 about to come out, and you know how they do. You know how they do 2Ks, man. 2Ks are the exact same, damn near every year. The only different 2Ks that we had that weren't piggybacking off each other probably was 2K16 wasn't the same. That was a different mechanic. Those were different mechanics. 2K17, different mechanics. 2K18 was garbage. That was the worst 2K of all. Bruh. I think I say this almost every video that I make. Some videos I probably might not even post sometimes. I'll be forgetting to post them. But, bruh, 18 was the worst 2K I have ever played in my life. I didn't even upgrade my player past the 85. I just upgraded his shooting for 18, and he was just cashing out from half court like it wasn't nothing, bro. Just, man, what happened? 19, I had a 6-7. That was my first game I had a 6-7. 19 was bad. It was actually a pretty good 2K that year. Then 20 came out. I played 20 for like half of the year. I played 20 half of that year because I don't think I was really on 2K that much. It was just 2K started taking a downfall. Then 21 came out. Then 21 came out and it was like everybody. I didn't play 21 at all. I honestly don't even remember the year 2021. Whatever I was going through it. I don't even remember that 2K coming out. But I heard it was good. I heard some people miss it, but I heard some people telling me it won't like that. Then 22 comes. 22 had this inconsistency thing where you got 2, 3, 4 games consistent as hell, shooting over 50%. Then you come back the next game. Bro, you going 0-6, 1-6, 1-7, 2-5. It's like y'all was just cashing out last game. Why is my shots all late and delayed all of a sudden now? Like, and 2K don't care about that. They don't care. And it's, I don't even want to expose it no more. I really don't want to expose what 2K is not doing and the mechanics of 2K and why things don't work. Like, it's a lot. It's a lot behind rebounding. It's a lot behind shooting, defense, building your player, having a good build, bro. I could just break all that down to y'all. I could break everything down to y'all, but I'm like, is it worth it? I probably should break it down to y'all. But concluding this, because we're about to get into the trailer for 2K24. What happened? I have 4 or 5 builds, bro. I have an inside out build. Never dropped that. Actually, I don't know. I don't remember. I'm not even gonna lie to y'all, bro. Because I be feeling like posting, then I get on 2K and 2K do pull some dumb stuff. I get off and I don't even feel like posting no more. But this season was just weird. It was real adaptive. It was real like weird. The randoms we got now, randoms nowadays. Yeah, we don't got no integrity in our randoms, bro. It ain't no, our randoms no longer have no integrity, bro. The randoms, they used to, man, what year was it? Was it 16? Bro, 2K16, bro, randoms used to play their heart out. We used to have, back before 19, was it 19? Or was it, I think it was before 18. I'm going to say before 18. Our randoms was decent. Like, you could go around, you could get a U-game. You could get in the game, yo, and y'all randoms be running that jump, bro. Y'all be running up against them squads. But nowadays, bro, you got people just coming into the games, coming into the rec, coming to the bridge, just playing not to win. It's like, bro, you get on this game, you spend money on this game. Everybody talk about being a fiend in the sweat. Well, shoot, back then, 3, 4 years ago, 5 years ago, when games was like that, shoot, when Modern Warfare 2 was popping, Call of Duty was popping, Halo was popping, Apex was booming, Fortnite was booming, bro. It was competitive, bro. We wanted to, like, it's thunder, god damn. Woo. But it was competitive, like, you wanted to be good. You wanted to be like that sweat, you feel me? Like, everybody like, hey, go outside, man, go outside. You stay on the game too long. Whole time, whether y'all know or not, I don't even be on the game like that. Some people are just good at games. Some people just naturally got that niche for games. Just like some people naturally got that niche for drawing. Some people naturally got that niche for dressing. Some people naturally got that niche for fashion. Some people just got that. Bro, me, I just got a niche for games, bro. I'm just good at games. I don't even have to be on the game. I don't even have to slave and sweat the game for a whole year to be good at that game. Like, bro, I hit 99 on my player in 2 or 3 weeks. 2 or 3 weeks just grinding. Hall of Fame and 12-minute quarters. Simple, that's easy. That's the easiest way to get your player up there. And I didn't really spend that much money on my build. That's the crazy thing about it. So it's like, if you're not good, then you're just not good. If you're good, then you're good, bro. Accept that. Accept that you're good, bro. Like, I get up here, I get like 100 clips. I'm not even gonna say 100. I'm gonna be a little bit more realistic. I get about 50 clips, shoot, in 2 weeks. A day, I probably get about 30. And then, That's a lot of clips, bro. And I don't, and my videos don't even be worth the 30 clips. Don't even be 30 clip videos, bro. They'd be 2 minutes. They'd be 2 minutes when probably got about 15 clips in there, bro. Because if it's any more clips than that, bro, it's going to be a 2 hour long video. I'm not lying. But, man, what I really want to get into this, this 2K24. I want to see the trailer, bro, because personally, I think I'm gonna drop one more mixtape. I was gonna drop some Dribble Moves. Actually, I had a video for y'all too. I had a video on Dribble Moves and Signature Moves, but I ran out of storage. That's my problem now. I run out of so much storage, bro. It's just so much stuff that ties into uploading stuff and making content on YouTube that sometimes you're just not gonna be able to do it. It's not that you don't want to do it. It's just stuff not allowing you to do it. But I'm gonna try and drop that video and see what my story is talking about. For real. Cause right now I just do everything on the phone. You feel me? I mean, I got my PC and stuff, but I be having to transfer stuff. I be having to save this file to this. I edit all my videos. I don't go to nobody. I don't pay for nobody to do my videos. I can learn how to do it myself. I mean, getting somebody to edit my videos would definitely make stuff easier for me. And down the long run, I probably will find an editor down the long run to save me time. You know, some stuff you got to do, you know, to benefit yourself type stuff. But let's get, hold up. Let's go ahead and smack into this. This 2K 24 for real, but y'all, I don't know. Like, this might be my last 2K, bro. I don't know. Look, and they just uploaded it 2 hours ago. I mean, 7 hours. They just uploaded it 7 hours ago. How long was 7 hours ago? It's 5 o'clock now. So 4, 3, 2, 1. 12, 11, 10. They dropped that at 10 o'clock this morning. If I'm wrong, let me know. I just kind of did that in my head. I just did the top of my head. But, all right. Let's get into it, man. Let me put my headphones on. Put the headphones on, bro. This is what happens when you've had headphones that work for 3 years. I've had these for about 3 years. They're some clutch headphones. They're some Rodecasts. These are good headphones. These are, like, I highly recommend these. I highly recommend. Careful on big names, because some of them, you might not get what you need out of them. But let's get into it. We're going to watch the official one first. We're going to watch the straight from 2K, the actual 2K, 2K channel. Alright, let's get into it. Just please don't let it be the same. Just don't let it be the same as 23, bro, because that's what I heard. So it looked like they're trying to put real animations, like, it seemed like they're trying to make the animations a little bit more realistic to like, the actual game. I don't know. That's what it's looking like, though. Like, it's looking a little bit more like, from what I just saw. Trailers ain't never really give us like what we wanted to see. Besides animations and stuff, they never really gave us what we wanted to see. Like, this is not what we want to see. Come Kobe on the joint, and who's the 12th most? See, 24th anniversary, Kobe edition. That joint probably gonna be like $100 in it. That was terrible. I'm not gonna lie. I didn't like that. Yeah, L trailer for 2K24. L trailer, bruh. L trailer. I don't ever want to see that. Can we see some gameplay? Can we see the game modes? Can we see like the My Team? I don't play My Team, but still, like, let's see the My Team. Let's see the My League. Show some previews of that. I ain't really showing us nothing but the fact that another game is about to come out. Another 2K24. Another replica. Another copy and paste. That's what it is. This is copy and paste. Y'all, let's go to let's watch. I wanted to watch Duke Dennis react to it because I definitely saw him react to it because he got to play it early. Duke Dennis got to play it early, so he dropped that like last week, I think. So let's watch. Let's take a look at his jump real quick, see what he got to say about it. Cause I know he probably got the same thing. He probably has the same stuff to say that I got to say about it. Or anybody who is in the 2K community, bro. If you've been playing 2K, you know. Like, if you've been playing 2K, bro, 2K is not the same. I don't care what nobody says, bro. It's not fun no more. I can play it all day long. I can drop 20 all day long. It's not fun. It's not fun to do. It's not fun. I hate to say it. It just sucks. It just sucks to say that, bro, because, man, that used to be a time where we come together, bro. We come together to wrap up, you know, getting the parties and stuff, getting the party chats, bro. Now everybody just on the game, just to be on the game. It's not fun. Let me see. I can't find it. Yes, I can. Okay. He said it's trash. I don't know if he did it on his page. Let me see. He must have did it on Twitch. He must have did it live on Twitch, because this is shown on somebody else's page. But let's look. Let's get into it.
They just need motherfuckers who not biased to go up there and tell them what the fuck is in that game. Shit, they need somebody, cause boy.
Duke Dennis, the biggest creator in the NBA 2K community, doing IRL stuff and everything, went off about 2K24 and the creator.
All right, shout out JMATTV. That's who uploaded this video. So I'm gonna put his link in the description. Shout out JMATTV for sure. Cause I wanna listen what he gotta say too. I'm listening to what he's saying over top of this video.
And all that stuff. I'm telling y'all, man, listen, you might want to get you a cup or something, cause you might need to sip on that sipping on for watching this. I'm telling y'all, this is crazy.
Hey, but look though, I played 2K24 early too now. Like, we played like an early version. Like, you gotta remember that the game don't come out for 2 more months. So we played like a really early version of that shit, bro. So like, I seen some new shit in there. And listen, y'all know me, bro. I'm gonna always say what's on my mind. I seen some shit that I know y'all not gonna like. And I told Mike Wayne, Mike Wayne watching me play, I told that nigga, I say, look, Mike Wayne, bro, goddamn, now the community is goddamn, they in a frenzy right now, you know what I'm saying?
Fuck your shit, like, dude, that's what I'm saying.
The community don't like adrenaline, bro. This adrenaline shit, bro, they don't like that shit, bro. It limits the motherfucking real creators. It limits everybody from doing what the fuck you really wanna do. You heard me? Like, all the dribblers and shit. I told them.
It, like, shortens up your playstyle. It, like, cuts down the playstyle 2K in general.
So, as we heard, Duke Dennis has confirmed that we y'all bringing adrenaline boost back to NBA 2K24. Now, for me, I'm not necessarily the biggest fan of adrenaline boost, but at the same time, I understand to an extent why they did it. 2K22, we had people flying left to right, and they just continued to go left to right. I don't have no problem with the left-right group style, me personally.
Left and right.
But if you do...
Let me pause the video right here. Left and right, right? So, so adrenaline is good and it's bad because certain players don't get that adrenaline, bro. So, while you... Me... I have hella stamina, bro. I have hella stamina. Cause I'm a content creator. I like drip, like, bro, I've been doing this since 15, bro. Bro, we want to dribble. We want to, we want our stamina. We want to be able to move. Cause for some reason, 2K got these weird animations. They have the weirdest animations that don't allow you to do certain things. It'll put you in like this ugly, you're like, bro, hold up. What did I just do? Why am I slowing up? Why am I stutter stepping on these moves? I'm trying to combo up. I'm trying to go to the basket. You got me in and out stutter stepping. Let's get back to it, Brian.
Really the biggest fan of Adrenaline Boost, but at the same time, I understand to an extent why they did it. 2K22, we had people flying left to right, and they just continued to go left to right. I don't have no problem with the left-right drip style, me personally. But if you're doing it like 2K22, where you can continue just to go left.
For all these people, for all these wannabe so-called comp stage players, y'all are not comp. Y'all are not comp. Y'all aren't stage players, bro. So left to right, getting a high speed boost, a high, bro, that's not comp. Y'all watch this video, all my wannabe comp stage players who say, yo, take me in with the playmaking take badges that don't even allow you to shoot. You just get 30 dribbling badges just to be able to dribble and miss every shot. Or going fade. Me, I combo up. I might hit on damn near every combo that you can hit with the animations I got. You feel me? I'm hitting combos. I'm come here, left, right. Oh, you thought I was going left again? No, I'm going right. I'm still going right. You feel me? You feel me? Like, these other players in comp, yo, see me in the stage. I don't know how many stage players I beat on a regular court, but that I didn't drop off by 20. It was like, bro, see me in the stage, man. I'm like, bro, you doing the same stuff in here that you gonna do in Antia. Only thing is, it's gonna be an ISO, and I'm still gonna lock you up. It ain't no difference. Like, all that left, right, left, right, left, right. Like, bro, crossover, behind the back, between the legs, step back. Misdirection. Not left, right, left, right. That's boring. Or the niggas that like to go left, right, and dunk the ball, rim running. That's not skilled at all, bro. I can do that. Any build on the game can do that. So that's not skill. That's not comp.
If they take it out of the game, I have no problem with that neither. But I do understand for my dribble guys. Yes, it is kind of cool since I'm the dribble guy, being able to do these special creative moves and stuff and don't have to worry about Adrenaline Boost.
Specific direction, go where you want to go to do this certain move. That's how you play the game. That's how you utilize everything in the game. You got over 1,000 animations in the game, bro. You got to do crossover speed boost. Crossover speed boost is like, bro, all these damn animations in the game, and that's the only thing you're doing. Come on now. Let's get back.
Take it out of the game, I have no problem with that neither. But I do understand for my dribble guys, yes, it is kind of cool seeing some of the dribble guys being able to do these special creative moves and stuff and don't have to worry about Adrenaline Boost.
But guess what, though? For everybody in the 2K community watching right now, now that I done been firsthand, like, in front of that shit, I tell y'all, bro, from here on out, shut the fuck up. Shut the fuck up. All that crying, tweeting, what you want in the game, what you don't want in the game, all that shit does not matter.
It don't.
You are,
like, it don't matter.
Bro, what you crying about the whole year for the past, all that shit, what you want in the game, all that shit.
It don't matter, bro. Like, that's why you just gotta adapt to the game. You just gotta adapt to the game. That's all
now,
it is.
Now, I'm not trying to speak for Duke Dennis on this one, but I really do think he was just trying to say people who go on Twitter and stuff like that and they be complaining about every little detail of the game, the creators that, you know, do that go on Twitter. Like, 2K is not really listening to that, man. 2K is not focused on
2K does not care about as creators. 2K does not care about park players. They don't care about neighborhoods. They don't care about that shit. They care about my team, my career, and my league, bro.
They don't care about what
it's
I say.
They care very little about neighborhood players.
Good or bad. It's a business. Business is supposed to make money.
But look, though.
And they're going to still make money regardless of who stopped playing. Because niggas keep buying the game.
It's some shit that's still in there that I don't like. So, as the game, you know what I'm saying, get closer to releasing shit.
Shout out my boy, Chris. Chilling right there.
They're not trying to cater to us, bro. That's not what the fuck they do.
They're not catering to nobody.
They're not trying to cater to what
they getting their money.
Because it's so like it's so
and they're running with it.
It's so many different motherfuckers saying this and that. It's so many, like, bro, you gotta think, it's built for every nigga in the world play 2K.
Yes, at some point. So it's, he's not
so
lying.
Everybody got something good or bad to say about it. So they sitting here trying to juggle what to do, who to listen to. And y'all, and
but they're not listening to the right people. That's the thing. They're not listening to the people that bring them the money. They're not listening to them people.
Play the game all year. Bro, the niggas who play the game all year are fucking dorks, bro. Them niggas are nerds. Them niggas are dweebs, bro. Them niggas are no life. They no life in the
no
game.
Life
and
in
they
the
not
game.
Gonna do shit but go to 2K and tell them what they want in the game. Not what needs to be in the game. They just gonna tell 2K what they want in the game, what's gonna benefit them. So y'all, 2K just need the right motherfuckers who not biased. They just need motherfuckers who not biased to go up there and tell them what the fuck is in that game. Cause don't send no dribble head up there. You feel me? Don't send no dribble head up there, cause they gonna tell you some dumb ass shit like take out stamina. That's what they, bro, don't send no biased ass motherfuckers up there, bro. Don't send Duke Dennis up there, cause I'm gonna turn the ankle breakers all the way up. I need to put some.
No cap, bro. Ankle breaker is like, useless.
They need to goddamn,
it works sometimes, but even on Hall of Fame, it don't work. I don't care what nobody say.
Care about the game, bro. I don't know who the fuck that is. To be honest, I don't know who that is, but. Shit, they need somebody.
They need somebody,
listen,
boy.
Listen, bro, look, I don't sugarcoat shit, though. I don't sugarcoat shit, bro. I was telling Mike Wayne, you know what I'm saying, what was good, what was bad, what I seen, what I didn't, you know what I'm saying, what I didn't really like, what was fire. They got some new fire shit in there. They got some the same old bullshit.
Same old bullshit. And they always gonna have the same bullshit with something. Like, whatever 2K to come out with.
I don't know if the game is ass, nigga. I played a fucking 2 month early demo, basically.
It's gonna be trash, bro. It's only but so much you can do with a preview game.
This what I'm telling y'all niggas, like,
and it's only but so much more you can add into that game. It's only but so much more you can change about it to make it better after it's already into, you know, preview play.
Now to sum it all up, man, Duke Dennis is right when he talks about we need some non-biased people, creators or whatever, to be able to come out there. Maybe 2K can do creators mixed with some kind of giveaway or something. They do some type of in-game giveaway where you get a chance to come and play 2K24. That's my marketing side. I'm a social media manager for a business. But they definitely need to pick people that are non-biased. I feel like I'm one of them. So I feel like I got
both sides
of the community. And I will be able to say, you know, I understand
one
why
thing
do
we
the,
don't
the
need
left, right. I mean,
is
adrenaline boost
somebody
left,
who's
right,
not
stuff.
Good
and
at the game
what that community
asking,
feels about
making
it. And I can
suggestions
see
on
about
the game.
Community that don't. But I'm non-biased with that. I understand both sides.
Like, I know
and
the mechanics of the game.
It is
I know the stuff that 2K do purposely.
So you
that they purposely put in the game so that it's not, you know, easy.
The game is most of the way done, though. So if you think the game isn't, the game, they're not in the last 2 months making a brand new game. The game is most of the way done. They're just fine-tuning
exactly.
things, and they let these guys get a chance
come out
to play the game.
Month.
Then we're going to have the creators
who
we're going to get to play
wrong with you.
The almost 99% finished version.
I'm
going to
drop one more mixtape before.
Hopefully they pick me to do it.
I'm
going to
drop one more mixtape before it's all
said
and done.
Give y'all all the information, just like I've been giving y'all all the information for 2K24. But if y'all ain't seen my video about Kaisa Nat's reaction to NBA 2K24, man, check
man,
out
Kaisa Nat don't even play 2K.
Right here.
I don't think you do. I like that. But, all right, man. So, that was that, man. That was that. We heard Duke Dennis. You know, he pretty much got the same views as me. You feel me? He pretty much got the same views as me. Now, don't get me wrong, man. You feel me? All these games get a clean slate with me. All of them get a clean slate. Even though I'm already knowing how it's going to turn out. Like, you know, if you play games, you know. You can't be oblivious to how games are made. Especially 2K. You can't be oblivious to how 2K is made. You can't be oblivious to that stuff. Like, you, there's some stuff you just got to go, all right, man. You know, 2K want the best. Just like 16. Again, going back to 16. Y'all remember when they took out speed boosting in 16? Oh, my gosh. That messed the community up, boy. That's when... Like, whenever they take something out the game or make it bad, there's always an exploit. Always. The exploits may not be that good, and they might be weird, but... The exploits might be... Being like, bro. We'll see though. You feel me? Let's go ahead. We heard 2K24. I mean, I'm not excited for it. I haven't been excited for 2K coming out in a while. But you know, I can play 2K. I don't have a problem with adapting with it. It's just sometimes it's hard to enjoy the game, bro. And sometimes it's hard to enjoy the game. But I like bringing content to y'all. I love it. I love it. I like playing the game. You feel what I'm saying? So you know, we'll come back with another video soon. Keep y'all updated. Stay tuned for this last couple mixtapes I'm gonna drop. You feel me? Just stay tuned for those. If y'all want a specific video, y'all gotta let me know. If y'all want a specific video, let me know. And if y'all want it dropped at a certain time, let me know that too. I don't got a problem with it. Cause man, y'all already know what time it is. It's your boy Trills, man. I'm out.
Many men wish death upon me. Blood in my eye, dog, and I can't see. I'm trying to be what I'm destined to be. And niggas trying to take my life away.